I'm talking about.
Trikes of Triumph.
Ladies and gentlemen, this year's 2012 Velo Crab team has been brought to you by Arcata Yoga Studio. Humboldt Brew. And the Arcata Bike Library.
2012 entrance to the Aquarian Age.
This is Bill Burton.
I am Bicycle Bill from the Arcata Library of Bikes. I will be hosting this coverage of the 44th annual Kinetic Race here in Humboldt County. Over 3 days and 42 miles, pilots will face street, sand, and sea on their handmade human-powered vehicles. Several thousand people have gathered here in Arcata, California to watch this glorious spectacle.
I'm Laura Thompson. I am the Bribe Master, and this is my third year racing. This is Matt Porr's fourth year racing Kinetic Sculptures. His first year was Team Dingbot and the Carriage of Calamity, and his second year was Team Fate with Hannibal 8. Last year in 2011, we were Team Road Warriors, and this year, Velo Crab.
I'm Matt Poor, team captain for the Velo Crab Kinetic Sculpture team. Roadkill Cafe is Dwayne Flatmo's six-seater Kinetic Sculpture. This machine has raced for over a decade in various forms. This year it is covered in roadkill carnage. Dwayne and his crew are costumed as carrion birds who are feasting on other peons and pit crew throughout the race. This is the Kinetic Sculpture Grand Championship. It is the original Kinetic Sculpture race. It is a 42-mile, three-day, all-terrain, human-powered vehicle race. This is equal parts parade, art festival, street theater. There is a component of racing. There are speed awards, but there's more awards for art, for being the first to break down, for having the best bribes, pageantry, costumes.
The Great Arcata to Ferndale Kinetic Sculpture Race has historically had a Le Mans start.
At the sound of the noon whistle, all team members must sprint across the street to their craft, then complete three laps around the plaza before crossing the start line. Go Team Velo Crab!
Thalon Hubbell, first-time Kinetic pilot and engineer. I fell in love with Kinetic sculpture racing in 2011. I followed the race on a bicycle through all 3 days, biking from Arcata to the start, finish, and back each day. I'm attracted to the Kinetic universe for its conspicuous use of human power. Also, I like its focus on creativity, ingenuity, and materials reuse. Last winter, Matt invited us to help build a team for the 2012 Kinetic Grand Championship. He surprised us in the spring by producing the main frame in secret. Kinetic vehicles come in a wide variety of styles, from handmade bikes, trikes, and quad cycles, to store-bought unicycles and tandems with art modifications. All are welcome.
The starting gates are open and the 44th Kinetic Grand Championship has begun.
The Kinetic Universe honors teams with a multitude of awards. Awards are given for being the fastest and the slowest, as well as being the middle of the pack. The Golden Dinosaur is given to the first team to break down after leaving the plaza.
Here you can see Spruce Deuce winning the Golden Dinosaur as they have broken down not two or three blocks off of the plaza.
Great job, guys.
Extra glory is bestowed on teams who can ace the race. To ace, a team must strictly follow all rules. Most importantly, an ace team must make it through the entire race without being pushed forward or being assisted. An ace team must not change pilots, and all pilots must remain on board throughout the race.
Look out!
Our team decided early on not to attempt acing the race for many reasons. Our team consists of 11 people, and we wanted to give everyone a chance to ride and share in the glory.
Here's the Kingfisher. Kingfisher was Rev 2 Kinetics. They came all the way from Washington for this race. This is their first year at the Humboldt County Kinetic Grand Championships. They brought a wonderful four-person quad cycle.
Pilots have ridden almost 10 miles from Arcata to the Manila Community Center. Here teams must make adjustments before entering the treacherous sand stage. Team Velo Crab has stopped to attach sand tires and adjust gears.
Some teams, such as the dirigible, have the large Hoosier tires and can roll straight onto the sand off the road. They're ready to go. But a lot of us who are using bike wheels and have alternate gearing setups strap on sand tires, change out gears, and enter the dunes, which require even lower gearing than any other part of the race. Thank you. Here are the fun guys. Fun guy himself, Brian Slayton, is a total character. His machine is huge, those giant wheels. He's had some really tough times the past few years in the race. It's incredible engineering feat, just that this thing moves at all. Regardless of acing or the engineering, they've got the whole thing. They've got the artwork, the engineering, the costumes, and the crowd appeal. Every time you see the fun guys cruising through, their team and the whole crowd all screaming fun guy. Fun guy!
Perhaps the most talked about portion of the race is the infamous dead man's drop.
Here, reporters and people who are filming from helicopters watch as this perilous 30-foot drop ends with a tight squeeze between trees. It's a sand dune that the vehicles have to negotiate, and it's the source of many exciting moments and bent wheels, and bent hearts, and bent glory.
This is a point where many machines are tested to their limits.
Can Team Velo Crab meet its challenge, or will the crab go belly up?
That was one of the most radical tricycle crashes I've ever been in. Our main concern at Dead Man's Drop was folding a wheel. We custom built the hubs on solid axles, so that would put us out of the race entirely. Our strategy was to charge the hill as fast as we could. In the sand, we had to coordinate pedaling to steer, so Matt was yelling out instructions the whole time. And I just remember him yelling, "Pedal! Don't pedal! Pedal! Go! Go! We're good! We're good!" And then, "We're not good!" And the next thing you know, I was standing on the ceiling, being showered by kinetic swag.
Thankfully, the crab was still intact, and Matt and Thalon survived too. They rolled the Crab over and continued on towards glory. After exiting the sand stage at Samoa, pilots ride across the Samoa bridges and into Eureka for the end of the first day.
We had an incredible team this year, comprised largely of cycle fanatics. This was evident from our large entourage of bikes. Many of our team members rode along for the entire race, and it was not uncommon to see the Crab surrounded by a half dozen bikers, even in the most remote parts of the course.
We did a lot of things that got us a lot of attention, all the things we did right, for the art, the engineering, for our team having fun and helping out other teams and just generally doing all that. But I think the thing that really, you know, really made us infamous this year was definitely flipping down Dead Man's Drop.
The end of day one. Time for some well-deserved congratulations, sleep, and beer.
You see coming up is the Apocalyptic Cockroach team. Previously, they were the Tempest Fugit and then the Tempest Fugitives in 2011. In 2011, they were the Kinetic Grand Champions. This year, they're coming back as the Apocalyptic Cockroach, which is a team headed up by James and Sarah Smith. Their machine is a center-articulating four-person quad cycle, all-wheel drive, in the land and water. It's a very beautiful machine, very fast. Mm-hmm.
Teams line up in anticipation for the water crossing. Pit crew and pilots rush to inflate and fasten flotation devices. Team Velo Crab has already earned the Golden Flipper Award at Dead Man's Drop, and they are not looking to secure the second Golden Flipper given for capsizing in the bay. That would be bad.
This year we did have a chance to water test, and it worked. Everything was pretty much fine, but the machine was a little bit tipsy side to side. It wasn't quite as balanced as we liked. So last minute, like 2 days before the race, we welded a couple new pontoon mounts onto the front that put the front pontoons wider and further forward, which we felt would balance it out correctly. But we didn't have a chance to actually test that system. These pontoon mounts were also part of what was responsible for the flip on Dead Man's Drop. Here you can see that we've not actually practiced exiting the water with the new pontoon mounts and running into some difficulties with them running into the boat ramp.
My name's Joe Labani. I live in Arcata, California. Been very proud to be included in this fantastic team. All right, so right here I'm sitting on the dock looking, thinking, all right, these guys are going to get out, and then they pretty much hit a stopping point right there. I realize the floats are dragging on the bottom of the ramp. So in a second here, I'm going to jump down. They're going to start untying the floats, and they're going to kick them out. What I didn't realize was that I was going to get a face full of water from Matt's heel, but it was totally worth it because that moment I was sitting there thinking, this is my job. This is why I'm here. And it felt good. I took that face full of water with glory and was proud of it. Here it is. Wait for it. And there's the splash right there. That's why I'm here.
With a little bit of help from our teammate Joe, we were able to discard the pontoons and ride out of the bay.
Back on the road, teams head 25 miles south to bucolic Lolita, California.
Leaving the freeway, we pull into the College of the Redwoods for the mandatory brake check.
Velo Crab team captain Matt Porr is ever ready to help other teams in need. Here they stop to loan the Humboldt Hot Sauce team the spare jack shaft. Perhaps it's the glorious spirit of goodwill that earned Matt and his team the coveted Racer's Choice Award this year. Next they tackle the steep Lolita grade.
Going over the Lolita Hill was not as challenging as I'd expected. It was hard for me to keep up pace with Joe, but we cranked hard and before we knew it, we saw the intersection sign at the top of the hill. Even though our frame was slightly bent from Saturday's crash, our trike handles smoothly at top speeds. Lolita Hill offers several minutes of uninterrupted coasting, and the Crab rolls along exceeding 30 miles per hour without listing or swerving. The last few miles of day two, racers turn west and pedal into strong headwinds towards Crab Park. All racers must camp closely to their sculptures.
Thank you.
As you're watching, you may notice some team members riding more than others. I would like to take time to mention our fellow crabs who work very hard on driving support trucks, setting up camp, and missing large parts of the race just to make this possible. We couldn't have done it without all of our team members. Thank you. The water crossing on Monday was canceled due to low tide. The Velo Crab team gets a slow start on the day and enjoys Eggs Benedict courtesy of the Humboldt Hot Sauce team.
You see Peter Wagner this year as the Black Forest Gnome. His team is always the BFG. Black Forest Gnome, big friendly giraffe, bouncing friendly gnome. But it's always the same whim cycle, eccentrically mounted rear wheel bounce cycle that he has been racing for over a decade at this point. Peter Wagner is based out of Davis, California.
Teams meet up at Fernbridge. At noon, they will take off together into the last few miles of the race and cross the finish line in Ferndale. This year, June Moxham, it's her 30th year racing, and she got the Kinetic Cop Award for riding high-heeled.
The Bigfoot team this year was Taco Truck last year. We shared Racer's Choice Award with them, which is very much an honor. They won art and pageantry, and they totally earned it with their gigantic Bigfoot and Bigfoot Hunter.
Coming up, we have the Kinetic Paranormal Society. This team is captained by Isaac Bluefoot and is a great example of just how inclusive, silly, and fun this race is. Essentially, this is a one-person puppet booth on casters that he sort of runs shuffles inside of doing puppet shows along the course. It is all about the theater and the fun and interacting with the crowd.
A little bit of history of the sculptures themselves. They keep changing their names as they come through the race each year with modifications to artwork and different crews.
Ken Beitelman's machine from 2011, simply titled Hook and Ladder, has been reincarnated this year with a slight modification. He added a T to make it Hook Ant Ladder, and you might have also noticed the giant red fire ant he added. Pilots furiously pedal through sleepy pastures in the final few miles of the Kinetic Grand Championship. Meanwhile, sculptures begin to cross the finish line on Ferndale's historic Main Street.
Perhaps Hobart Brown, a god of Ferndale, California, is looking down at Team Velo Crab coming in to his hometown 44 years after he started the Kinetic Sculpture Race. Three days and 42 miles later, the Kinetic Grand Championship ends to fanfare in Ferndale, California. It's all smiles and glory in the sleepy farm community where Kinetic Racing was born 44 years ago. Team Velo Crab crawls towards the finish line, bent but not broken. The Velo Crab team won four awards this year. The Golden Flipper Award, Racer's Choice, the Teddy Bear Award, the Port Townsend Committee Choice. This is Bill Burton reporting from Humboldt County, California. This is the 2012 Kinetic Sculpture Grand Championship.
Ladies and gentlemen, your 2012 Velo Crab team is made up of members: Brett Selvig, Jessie Cortijo, Joe Labani, Laura Thompson, Lewis Wilson, Matt Porr, Nathan Graham, Noah Billings, Ryan Leary, and Thalon Hubbell.
Thank you.